Okay, I think we're live.
Let me see.
And we're going. Hey, Hazel, say hi.
And what?
It says it's live, so I think it is.
Why are we? What's?
Okay. Anyway, let's get started. We are gonna make a cute little shamrock today with felt and fabrics and button and all that kind of stuff. Some of you picked up, oh good, Brooke's watching, so we know it's working, Hazel.
Yay!
a little kit from the house. And now this, we're not going to do this in real time, so it's going to be hard to like sew as we go. But you can always watch this video and, you know, like rewind it and keep watching and so you know what you're doing. But it's pretty simple. You should have some templates like this and some felt. Any kind of felt will do. There's all kinds of felt. There's felt with patterns, felt with sparkles, all different shades. So I just have all these scraps that I keep from when the girls do projects and I do projects, and I've cut out. So from our template, you need 4 hearts that are small and 4 hearts that are large. So they need to be each a different color. So I've got 4 light colored green and then 4 just like regular green that are bigger. So that is the first thing you need to do. Easy peasy. If you're wondering, or a trick you can do to cut stuff like this, especially when you're doing more, like if I have my piece of felt, I can fold it into half or into pieces, put what I'm gonna cut onto it and either trace it with a Sharpie or some chalk and then cut it out together so I could get 2 at one time. oh, you're gonna make lesson plans for your at-home learning class? I don't know if this is 3-year-old approved, but maybe you could try it. Anyway, so I've got my hearts cut out, and then the next step is very easy. So you'll have to get a needle, any kind of needle. So I've kind of tried to put this white down. Hopefully we can see better. Just thread it up, and remember how we thread our needle? We just take the eye, and you get your thread really small, and you shimmy it through the eye of that needle. And I'm using embroidery floss, but you can use any kind of thread. And then you have a short tail and a long tail. Now, we're gonna tie that knot again. So this is also something else. We gotta keep practicing, girls. So we're gonna make that circle. You're gonna put your tail inside your circle and then push it together, okay? Now, with my hearts, I'm gonna start with the big ones, and I'm gonna go to the tip of the heart and just make a big stitch up any side, pull it, oops, let's do it again, and then make a big stitch right over, just like that. And then, see how it makes a big stitch? When I pull that, it's gonna go pull the 2 pieces, well, pull them together tight like that. And then I'm gonna keep it on the same string and like just keep adding hearts. So I'll go up from the bottom, make that big stitch and put it on my string. Now I'll do another one. So there's 4 all together. Up from the bottom, big stitch. And see, I didn't even cut that very good. It's still gonna work. So not a problem. Thanks, Mom. Oh, Katie's doing homework. Ugh. Apparently here, they have an option to do it or not, Katie. Go in and out. So I've got all 4 on my string together. And then I'm just gonna pull. And see how when I pull that, it kind of, well, the whole thing falls apart. Let's just do it real quick again. You know what? That's a good lesson. My knot's too small. So look what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna just tie it again like that, right on the back. Goodness. There. So that's good. We need to see that again anyway. So up from the bottom, big stitch. Just keep my chain a-going. Up from the bottom, big stitch. Well, everything's falling apart today. Y'all should have seen a shepherd was pitching a big fit right before we went on. So thank goodness Miss Heidi came over. Y'all have to hear that. I don't know what's going on with that baby boy. My mom's going to have to come collect him. Okay, so keep a stitching, stitching, stitching. One more. Up. Down. Okay, so I've got my chain. And see how they're all scrunched together? Now, look. They'll scrunch together and you've got the start of your four-leaf clover. So I'm gonna take all four and I'm just gonna make a big stitch in the middle to connect them like this and hold them together. So that's pretty much it. And then you're gonna do the same thing with your small hearts. So hang on, it just takes a second. So you're gonna go up from the bottom, make a stitch and keep going on the chain, up and down. Hey, Gabby. I hope you're not going nuts over there. Up and down, up and down. And then we've got all four of those on our chain and we're gonna pull them down onto the bigger ones, okay? So just like that. And then all you have to do, and you can make sloppy stitches here, just put a bunch of big stitches in the middle. See how I'm kind of arranging it how I want it to be? Just all through all the layers, just make a bunch of big stitches to hold them together. So just go up and down, however you want. Hazel, you're being funny. Like that. And now you've got your four-leaf clover. And you can leave it just like that, which would be cute. You could add a safety pin to the back or a hair clip or something. See, that would be cute. Just like that. But we're going to make it a little fancier by adding a button. So I still have string on the back. So I'm just going to go all the way through. So, Hazel, you should do this beside me so I can see if it's working. Up. I'm going to find my button. Oh. See, oh, here, I have this fancy button. I was so lucky, and Murmurum found a lady who was getting rid of some of her grandmother's sewing stuff, and she had all these really cool gold buttons. They're just really neat. So I'm just going to stick it on. See, it's a shank button, so you just thread it on your needle. Very easy, and then make another big stitch right in the middle, just like that. Pull it down. And you've got your button in there. I'm gonna keep rearranging my little deals. And that is a little bit fancier. Now, what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna tie this off. And I'm gonna do that by taking a little stitch back here. Just a small stitch, pull almost, and then put my thread in that loop and pull tight. And I'm gonna do that one more time because I don't want that button to fall off. So small stitch, put my thread inside that loop, my needle, and pull tight. Okay, so now we have just a basic, cute little four-leaf clover. And what I did to this, just to make it like that, because I thought it'd be cute, like a little pin or something, is I took just some scrap fabric, anything you have, and I cut a circle. So I used like something like this. Just put it down here, get your chalk, trace it out like that. You can use a coffee mug's a good size, a small bowl, anything. It doesn't have to be a perfect circle, that's for sure. And then I'm gonna get my favorite scissors and I'm just gonna cut around real quick. See that selvage part right there? You're gonna wanna cut that off if you have that piece on your fabric because it just won't look as cute. And we want them to be cute. So just a nice rough circle. So I've got that part. And then if you want, you can use extra felt, or you can use extra fabric or ribbons or rickrack. I think I may cut a little bit of ribbon. And then, oh, and I found that thing. I thought that would be cool. I don't know what it's from. Probably a package or something. Some Christmas ribbon. But fabric ribbon is super cute too. And you just cut it into strips. That's all you gotta do. And you always, right, Mom? You gotta make your little tails like that. You gotta cut a V to make it look professional. So here's how you cut your V. Sorry, Hazel's very distracting. So, you just take the end, and I fold it, and on the where the folded part is, you just cut down like that, and then you have a perfect V. Isn't that cool? All right, so let's finish this up. I know you guys have lots of things to do.
In quarantine. Right.
Okay, Hazel. So we've got this, we've got our circle, we've got our little ribbons and things to dress it up. So to make the circle kind of bunchy like this, you can just take in the middle, and you're just going to do kind of the same thing you did with those deals. And you're going to, well, tie a knot in your thread, which I'm not doing very good at today. So I'm just going to make a boop, a knot. And I'm going to double knot it this time so it doesn't come undone. And I'm just going to make a big X in the middle. So make a big stitch like that. And then come over to the side and do it again. And then pull and see how it bunches up. Which those make really cute flowers and stuff if you're still into hair bows. Put a big bead in it. Super cute. So I've got that. I can add it to the back of my little thing, stitch it on. Again, just one big stitch in the middle. You've got it there, it's already done. And then add your ribbons. So you could stitch these on, or if you're just ready to be done, go heat up the glue gun and take it on the back, get your ribbons and glue them to the back like that. Otherwise, just take it just like we've been doing, one big stitch right to the back, stitch that on. Maybe I want this shiny thing is kind of cool. Put it on the back. One big stitch over. Stitch it on. There is no right way to do any of this, guys. So my girls that have been coming, y'all know this. And if you don't like what happened, just undo it. Try it again. It's no big deal. Okay? So you just keep adding until you have all the ribbons and things you want. And then, of course, tie off the end. You can trim it up. Like, I think my little hearts are a little big, so I would probably come back and trim them down a little bit. You can add a safety pin to the back, pin it on yourself. You could add hot glue. Like, you could get these barrettes, or if you have an old hair bow you don't like, hot glue that to the back and put it on. I'd like to see Hazel wear one, wouldn't y'all?
No, they won't.
She'd be so cute in her ponytail. She's got a beautiful ponytail.
Mom, no.
Yes, I do have the rainbow elastic, Gabby. So it's just sitting here waiting on you guys. Anyway, so that is that. And I've got one other very quick thing for those people that have the little kit. And I've got a few kits left. So if you want the stuff to kind of play around with this, you are welcome. Just message me and I'll let you know. But in the kit, I put a little extra felt in a pattern like this to do a little beanbag shamrock. And so easy. I sewed this one on the machine. If you have a sewing machine, do it that way. It's super fast. If not, I'll show you how to hand stitch it real fast. But you're going to cut two of these shapes, any color. So I have two real fast. I'm going to put them wrong sides together because the cool thing with felt is that you don't have to worry about those edges, right? So our seams can be on the outside. So that's what I like, doing easy, crafty projects with felt. Now, if you're going to make the beanbag and you're going to stitch it by hand, you've got to stitch it really small. So I'm going to show you very quick, just a simple how to start that. And then, sorry, gosh, I'll let y'all go. So I've got it matched up pretty good. Right sides together. Hey, Miss Hardy. I'm going to put one little stitch in. And then, look, I'm going to make just a little running stitch over and back up from the bottom to the top. Now, this is how I do it. You may do a stitch where you go around like this, and that works too. Whatever you like is fine. The point is you need a small stitch and you need to hold it together. Because what I put inside of this is a little bit of cotton and then these beans, like these are black-eyed peas that I just had. Anyway, because they feel really cool and it's real heavy and nice and you can throw it at people. Hazel hates it when I throw stuff at her, but we could throw it at her. You could practice your spelling words while tossing it back and forth.
Why would you want to throw
you
it at
You could practice
me?
Your math facts, or for younger kids, throw it and say, hey, toss it onto the something yellow, and they could toss it onto the yellow spot on the floor, which would be Peggy's pee probably in our house. But who knows? They're really fun. So you could try it with rice inside or just cotton. But I really like the weight of the black-eyed peas. So let's see how to finish this. So you'd stitch all the way around. Just little, little, little. Nice small stitches. And then you'd stop. Like I'd go all the way around and I'd stop like right there. And then I'd put my beans in, and then I'd stitch it back up so it was all full. Now what I did here, see, look, I didn't stitch, like I stitched over the stem because there's no point in putting beans in the stem. And then that's a good little thing you can grab onto. So that is what we have today. So remember, keep just rewind, watch again, and keep practicing. It all takes lots of practice. You just got to keep doing it. There's no wrong way, and have fun. Tomorrow, we're going to shrinky dink it, and I'm going to show you guys how to make a cool tassel and a little shrinky dink. And I'll have kits for that too. So if you want that, they'll be out on the porch in the morning, and I'll do some more messages about it. Did I forget anything, Hazel?
I don't know.
You don't know? That was a lot.
Yeah, it's 17 minutes, almost 18 minutes.
Hazel says it's too long.
Yeah.
Anyway. All right, so I'm signing off. I'll save all this on my Facebook page and try to upload it to my new YouTube page. And hopefully you guys can make some cool stuff. All right, talk to you later. You're so awesome. Bye.
I got this. Hello.